children, welcome back to our English grammar class. And in today's session, we are going to see in what situation you can use the tense. That is the simple present tense. In Tamil, we can say it as nigargalam. So, in our previous video, we have learnt about where we can use simple present tense or what is the simple definition for simple present tense. Do you remember that? Yes, we can use simple present tense in verbs that are used to express action taking place in the present time. So, here the end word is present time. If the action is taking place in the present time, then you can use simple present form. Is it clear to you? ஒரு சென்டென்ஸில் நம்ம வந்து எங்கே வந்து ப்ரெசன்ட் டென்ஸை யூஸ் பண்ணலாம்னா, இப்போ ஒரு செயல் நடந்துகிட்ருக்கு, நான் இப்போ இங்கே பேசிகிட்டு இருக்கேன், அப்போ நீங்கள் வந்து அதை சிம்பிள் ப்ரெசன்ட்ல சொல்லலாம். ஸோ ஒரு ஆக்ஷன் நிகழ்காலத்தில் நிகழ்ந்து கொண்டு இருக்கிறது, அதை பற்றி நீங்கள் பேசுகிறீங்க அப்படின்னா, அங்கே நம்ம என்ன டென்ஸ் யூஸ் பண்ணலாம்? சிம்பிள் ப்ரெசன்ட் டென்ஸ். நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சீ த த்ரீ சிம்பிள் ரூல்ஸ் இன் விச் யூ ஹாவ் டு யூஸ் சிம்பிள் ப்ரெசன்ட் டென்ஸ் கம்பல்சரிலி. ஓகே, ஸோ வித்தவுட் எனி doubt, you have to use it here. If you are seeing a sentence that it related to habits or it related to the universal truth, then without any doubt, you can use simple present tense to that sentence. So without any delay, let's move into our today's session, okay? So see that first, before that see here, the simple present has been used in the following ways. So we use simple present using this following ways in a sentence, or while you are speaking a sentence, while you are writing a sentence, you have to follow certain rules where we can use simple present tense. Okay, so coming to the first rule, what is the first rule? To state an all time truth. So what is the first rule? To state an all time truth. So here we are talking about all time truth, otherwise we can say it as a universal truth. So while you are talking about a universal truth, then for that particular sentence you have to use only simple present form. Okay, so you know what is a universal truth is, right? It is common to all and it cannot be changed. For example, the sun rises in the east. It is common and it is never changed, right? So the sun rises in the east is a universal truth. So while you are writing or speaking about a universal truth or all-time truth, then you can use simple present to that particular sentence. So this is our first rule. And for the first rule, we will see some of the examples, right? So see here, the sun and the moon create tides in our ocean. So here, what is the present form? Create. Okay, உருவாக்குது. எது உருவாக்குது? சன்னும் மூனும் சேர்ந்து தான் என்ன டைம்ஸ் இன் ஆர் ஓஷன், ஓஷனில் ஏற்படுற அலைகளை உருவாக்குது. நம்ம சீக்க போனோம்னா சில டைம் வந்து அலைகள் ரொம்பவே வேகமாக இருக்கும், சில டைம் வந்து ரொம்பவே ஸ்லோவாக இருக்கும். திஸ் ஆர் டியூ டு த ஆக்ஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் சன் அண்ட் த மூன். திஸ் இஸ் த யூனிவர்சல் ட்ரூத் தட் வி கே நாட் சேஞ்ச், ரைட்? த சன் அண்ட் த மூன் கிரியேட் டைட்ஸ் இன் ஆர் ஓஷன். ஸோ வாட் இஸ் மோர் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிள் ஹியர்? த சன் அண்ட் த மூன் இஸ் த ரெஸ்பான்சிபிள் ஃபார் த டைட்ஸ் இன் ஆர் ஓஷன். ஸோ இட் கிரியேட் இட் இஸ் இன் வாட் ஃபார்ம்? நவ் இட் இஸ் இன் த ப்ரெசன்ட் ஃபார்ம், பிகாஸ் வி ரைட் த ஆக்ஷன் வேர்ட் ஆஸ் இட் இஸ். ஸோ இட் இஸ் அ சிம்பிள் ப்ரெசன்ட் ஃபார்ம். ஸோ வைல் யூ ஆர் டாக்கிங் அபவுட் அ யூனிவர்சல் ட்ரூத், தென் யூ ஷுட் ரைட் இட் இன் த சிம்பிள் ப்ரெசன்ட் ஃபார்ம். வி வில் ரைட் அனதர் எக்ஸாம்பிள் டு சீ ஹியர். வாட்டர் boils at 100 degree Celsius. So see here, what is the verb? Here, boils. So water boils at 100 degree Celsius. Of course, it is a universal truth, right? What is the water boils when it reaches 100 degree Celsius? So it cannot be changed. So if you are talking about a universal truth or all-time truth, you have to use the simple present form. And you just wrote create the verb as it is. But in the second sentence, we added yes to the verb. Why? Do you have any idea? Yes. In our previous video, I have taught that. What if you are writing a pronouns like he, she, it, and after that pronoun, if you are using any verb, then you have to add yes to that. Okay, so these are nouns, and here we are talking about what? The sun and the moon, the two things, that is, they create tides in our ocean. So they, after the they, you should not use any yes to the verb. But if a pronoun like he, she, it comes, and after that we are using a verb, you have to add yes to the verb, right? Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Why here is? Because you can say it as it boils at 100 degrees Celsius. So here we are using it, and after that the verb follows the yes form. So this is a simple present form, and the first rule is to state an all time truth. Okay, now coming to the second one, to talk about habits or routine. What? To talk about habits or routine. Habits na enna? Nammalude palakkam chinna vayasula irundhu namma onna follow pannittu varuvom illaya adha nam enna solluvom habits palakkam appo solluvom. Or routine. Routine na enaduna palakkama. Namma palakkama ethana manikku dhaan elundhuvom, palakkama indha seyala seivom, palakkama na vandu sunday ana inga poven. So this is known as habits or routine. So when you are talking about habits of our daily duties or routine, daily routine, then that you can use simple present form. Okay, is it clear to you? We will see the example. See here, I go for a walk every morning. I go for a walk every morning. So see here, in this sentence, what is the present form? Verb. It is go. So here I use the present form because it is my daily habit that every day I go for a walk. So I go for a walk every morning. So if you are referring a daily habit or a daily routine, you can use simple present form in front of that. Okay, so we will see another example too. See here, she learns to play the violin on Sundays. So here, see the verb learns. Here I wrote learns because in front of that we used the pronoun she. So I told you that he, she, it. After that, if the verb comes, then you have to add yes to the verb to show the simple present form. So see here, she learns to play the violin on Sunday. So it is her routine. On every Sunday, she goes to a violin class and learns to play the violin. So it refers her Sunday routine. So if we talk about a habit or routine of a particular person or anybody, then you can use present tense in that sentence. Okay, so coming to the third rule, to talk about something is true for the present time. So if you are talking about some sentence or something and that is true for a particular time, that is true for the present time while you are talking and the incident is true, then for that sentence you can use present form. Okay, and later it can be changed, but while you are talking at that time it is true, then you can use present tense to that sentence. For example, see here, I can tell you I like ice cream. I like ice cream. So here like, why I use here present form? Because it is true for the present time. Now I like ice cream. Tomorrow my likings may be different. I like fruits. Or day after tomorrow I like vegetables. It changes, but now I'm speaking and at that particular time it is true. So while you are talking about something is true for the present time, then you can use present tense in that sentence. What is that? I like ice cream. Okay, so next sentence, see here, she plays the basketball basketball to school team. So see here, she plays the basketball to school team. So this is true for the present time. Tomorrow she may be rejected from that team, but now she is playing to the basketball team of school. So if an incident or if something is true for the present time, you can use present form in that sentence. So students, in this class we have learned the three different rules where we can use simple present tense in a sentence. I repeat the rules once again. See here, the first rule is to state an all time truth. If you are referring a universal truth or if you are speaking about a universal truth, you can speak or write it in present form. Okay, the next rule is to talk about habits or routine. Yes, if you are talking about someone's daily routine or daily habits, then you can use what? Simple present form to deliver that sentence. And the third one is to talk about something is true for the present time. For a particular period of time, if you are talking about that incident, it is true, then you can use the simple present form. Later it may change, but while you are talking it is true, then you can use simple present tense. So students, in this class you have to learn where or in what situation you can use simple present tense compulsorily. And in our next session, we will learn another interesting topic. Thank you for watching.